Hey folks, welcome to Market Intraday Analysis by InTheMoneyStocks.com, your leaders in pure technical analysis, avoiding all that Wall Street hype. Today, Tuesday, April 28th, 2009. Well, we're seeing a little fluctuation in the markets currently. We were actually making our way to the highs of the day in this market, and then we all of a sudden got a little bit of a sell-off here as the Treasury auction just finished up. Now, those of you that follow Treasuries and know all about that stuff know that it really plays a key part in what the market does overall, and you're seeing that right now. You can see we were actually trading up as high as my resistance line on my chart right here at about 86.25, and then in that one candle after we got word of this Treasury auction, we sold all the way back down here. So you are a little weaker now. The interesting thing is you can note here I have some key trend lines, and one of them follows from the high here to the closing highs here right to the high of the day from this morning, and we actually never really got above that and now sold off back below. So keep an eye on this channel. Also, I have a trend line here I want you to watch very, 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 very closely. This one from the low of the day to the secondary pivot low of the day to this point. We are trading below that now, so my question would be is this a near-term breakdown in this market this afternoon? You know, only time will tell, but I figured I wanted to tell you about this initially right away because it is so important. Okay, now let's talk a little bit about the markets. What are we seeing in the markets today? We are seeing the S&P up half a point, Dow up 5 points, and the NASDAQ up about 3 points. So the market very, very neutral on the day. Was up quite a bit more. We were actually up about 8 points on the NASDAQ. We were up a point plus on the S&P, but we've just cut that in half on this little bit of selling that came in. Now, the market saw some interesting things today. We saw continued selling this morning, causing the market to gap down. Now, those of you that know the video yesterday, we talked about the key resistance levels right up here and then up here, and you can see how they worked beautifully. And from yesterday's video, we sold all the way back down, perfect symmetry in this market, coming all the way back down to this support line, and we got a bounce beautifully off double bottom support into the close. Now, those of you that know pattern recognition, and again, I want to stress this, folks, we focus on price, pattern, and time and technical trendline analysis. That's everything we focus on, and it serves us better than anyone else out there on the street. Why? Because it's more accurate. You don't have to get the nonsense of Wall Street, the constant nonsense of major players. The patterns play out regardless. Now, what you can see here, folks, those of you that know pattern, big down move, sideways to slight move up. You should know by now this is somewhat of a bearish pattern off this move that dictates you should have another fall. You got the gap down today. Now, every gap down in this market over the past, it seems like 6 to 7 to 8 weeks, has been a buying opportunity in the near term. Yesterday, we gapped lower. What happened? We rallied to gap fill. Today, what happened? We gapped lower. We rallied to actually the high pivot area from yesterday right up in this area. And I do want to stress that. Notice how the high point push on this market is exactly where we came into here and just touched before the sell-off, which happens to coincide with my green trend line. Now, the green trend line goes all the way back to this point here and actually even further. So I want to show you why it's so important, folks. I mean, these are big, big levels from all the way back from this pivot high as well. So these levels that I have on my charts are absolutely important, and you have to follow them like a religious book. That's how important they are, folks. So now, again, you can see we just hit the, earlier this morning, we hit the green trend line, and we also touched on this pink one. Now we hit this green trend line again, closed back below the pink line, and above, below this one as well on the downside. And you can see how now the markets all of a sudden seems to be a little on the weaker side and starting to tick down. Now, we could easily reverse back up. Remember, the 3 o'clock time frame yesterday from 3 to 4 was probably one of the most volatile times on a period of about an hour I've ever seen intra-candle. And what I mean by that, look at the size of these reversal candles. Down, up, down, up, down. Just an unbelievable amount of reversals, and they're huge ones too. So I'm a little interested to see what 3 o'clock today brings us, whether or not we have this whipsaw action that we saw yesterday. Ultimately, it was a beautiful bearish pattern in spirit of bear flag, which resulted in the down move today, and those of you that know pattern should be recognizing that by now. But overall, it didn't matter. Again, the market is in this bullish mode right now. We're in a mini bear, a bull market throughout a big bear market, and what happens right here, what we're seeing, is that whenever we gap lower, the market is having buyers come up. Now, the interesting thing is this. There will be a day in the not-too-distant future where that doesn't work, where you gap lower and just have a gap and go to the downside, where the market just rips to the downside continually. Everyone else buys thinking it's going to bounce, and it doesn't. Trust me, the setup is coming for that. It's just a matter of which day is that. Do we go higher first before we sell off? Do we go lower? Now, keep an eye on this, folks. This candle is very important to me. Do we close below the 20 moving average? You can see the 20 moving average sloping right here, right at this point. Do we close below the 50, which is sloping down here as well? And if we do break lower, the 200 moving average here in green is sliding up to meet right here at this yellow trend line, right around 85.60 for now. So there's a lot of things at work, folks. Again, the markets, a lot of people blame the market gap down this morning for some more fears on the swine flu as it continues to kill people in Mexico and have a, you know, so far in the U.S., no one's died from it. So again, I'm not that worried about it at this point. Could it get worse? Absolutely. But for now, it seems like the market overall is containing itself. We're actually trading flat to slightly higher on the day. Again, Goldman, the financials are weaker. Now, the interesting thing is this, and I pointed this out to my premium subscribers, folks, at InTheMoneyStocks.com. If you want to become a premium subscriber and get the news and the info as is, really the newspaper prior to the day it comes out, what if you could get the newspaper for tomorrow, today? That's what we try to give you. We try to educate you on how we come to those issues and those conclusions as well. But overall, what the interesting thing is, I pointed this out, I was furious last Friday when they decided to release the stress test to the banks and only give the market the criteria. And I said, well, I mean, anyone here is naive not to think that the information is going to get out. Well, sure enough, it did, folks. Bank of America and Citigroup basically failed the test, it looks like, and they were selling off. They initially gapped lower. The overall financial sector today is on the weaker side. Goldman Sachs is lower on the day. You can see Bank of America down 75 cents. That's one of the ones that failed that stress test, apparently, and needs to raise capital. Citigroup, same thing. JP Morgan is bucking the trend up 60 cents today. So you're really seeing a little wishy-washy avenue here where you have financials actually weaker, and believe it or not, commodity stocks, which gapped lower this morning, are stronger. ExxonMobil. ExxonMobil is a key one for the commodity index. This has earnings on Thursday, and it is trading up about 80 cents on the day. Beautiful move on ExxonMobil here. But long story short, folks, that's what we're seeing for now. Now, I want to go back to the spiders. You can see the market down ticking here, folks. Now, again, I just want to point this out. See this pattern yesterday? We had a big up move and then a sell-off. That was today. And then yesterday, big up move and a little bit of sell-off. Or even you could look at this sell-off and then double top. Same type of pattern. And I want you really to recognize these consistencies in the market. Notice again, up move, pull back, double top, then decline. Today, up move, pull back, almost double top, or just about double top right here. And now decline. So could this be another situation where we have the same type of pattern developing from day to day? And these synergies, these consistencies, you want to be able to isolate, because trust me, it's not the first 2 days in a row we've had where we've gapped lower and the market's made a move up. I mean, I could show you going back. Even though we gapped up here, we still went higher by the close. Okay, let's go even back another day. All right, here again, gap down, up. Or gap down right here, up, and then a pullback, and then up even more. So you're seeing these patterns, and this is the result of psychology, folks. You got to understand this psychology. We're going to see if it plays out today again. Very curious to see, but ultimately what I'm looking for is a change in psychology when we get either a gap up or a flat open and then a sell-off and just start heading down, gap and go, if you will, to the downside. It should be very interesting to watch for. Now, none but less, I want to focus on really the remaining levels you want to watch for. First of all, you're on support here at the 20 moving average. Anyone can see that. You can see the 20 sliding right through here. That's at about 85.90. If we break 85.90 here, you look for the double test of this pivot low right down here at 85.60. If that breaks, by the way, that level is the 200 moving average as well, so that would be a double support line right there currently. If that breaks, then you look for down towards the lows of the day down here, going back to around $85 or $84.75. On the upside, should we start to make a move up, you want to start to look for a break of this trend line again, and then a hit of the green trend line. Green trend line currently sits at about 86.25. If that breaks, you're going to look for this slanted trend line from the high here to the absolute high yesterday, and that's coinciding with a level of about 86.30 right now, and if we get through that, then you're looking at 86.65, and then obviously just look for the pivot highs the rest of the day on the way up, and you can see them pretty clearly all the way up here. So those are the levels you're going to be watching in the intraday. I just want to focus quickly, folks, but nonetheless, I think this is a very important one down here. Take the low of the day to the pivot low, and you can see we're right hinging on this breakdown of this, holding on to the 20 moving average. We're now getting a little bit of a bounce now, so we want to see if this continues to float higher. Let's go to the 60-minute quickly. Really, you've been trading in a 60-minute range here over the last, ever since the high from two Fridays ago. Now you can have not taken out that high. This could be looked at as a slightly bearish pattern, hugging the 20 moving average. average. If that sells, you're going to look for the 50 moving average on the 60 minute, then the lows of the day, and then actually you'll watch for pivot lows coming down into this area. Again, folks, I just want to encourage you, come join and check out the Research Center. It just contains a ProTrader watch list, which is a bullish bearish calls on various stocks and ETFs, and it's by our ProTraders, all our traders out there. We talk to them, we see what they're focusing on, we take one or two or three plays from each of them and put them on that bullish or bearish, telling you which direction they are looking for that to go. Doesn't mean they're in the play, it means they're isolating it as a possible move and to be on watch. Daily market report with key levels on gold and oil and all the rest. Have a wonderful day, folks. We'll talk to you soon.